I'd like to welcome everyone to our service of lesson and carols. We begin with the reading that reminds us that this Christmas event of the birth of our Savior just not happened. God had planned it out so that when the fullness of time had come, God sent forth his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those under the law so that we might receive adoption as sons. Please rise for the processional hymn. Our order of service is in the printed handout. We have been called here this day in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins to God, our Father. Merciful God, we humbly confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean.
We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your sleep, lay in the manger. Have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen.
The Word of God tells us that the Lord is compassionate and gracious, slow to anger, and abounding in love. He will not always accuse, nor will he harbor his anger forever. He does not treat us as our sins deserve or repay us according to our iniquities. For as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his love for those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he removed our transgressions from us. as a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. Live in peace. Your sins have been forgiven. Amen. Please rise. We continue with the psalm from Isaiah 9. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwell in the land of darkness, on them has light shined. For the yoke of his burden and the staff of his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For every youth and every warrior, for to us a child is born, to us a son is given. The government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Of the increase of his government and of peace there will be no end, on the throne of David and over his kingdom.
to establish and to uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time forth and forevermore. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
And let us pray. O God, you make us glad with the yearly remembrance of the birth of your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that as we joyfully receive him as our Redeemer, we may with sure confidence behold him when he comes to be our judge. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. We confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand.
Please be seated for the singing of the next hymn. Our first lesson is taken from Isaiah 11, verses 1 through 9. Just as with movies today, there are trailers to advertise and to tell us what the theme and a such thing is about. Here, Isaiah, using the picture language of the Old Testament, from the return to the Garden of Eden to the destruction of evil, with the ending of war, and finally, the deliverance of God's people. In these short verses, he contains it all. We read, "There shall come forth a shoot from the stump of Jesse. A branch from his roots shall bear fruit, and the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, and his delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide disputes by what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. And he shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt of his waist, and faithfulness the belt of his loins. The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the young goat, and the calf and the lion and the fatted calf together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the cobra, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the adder's den. They shall not hurt or destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. This is the word of our Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We find a gospel lesson, such as in the Garden of Eden, as God deals with the evil one. Here, we have a faithless king who receives the promise of the great king, Jesus, and how he will be born. And Isaiah said, "Hear then, O house of David, is it too little for you to weary men, that you weary my God also? Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We continue with the singing of the hymn on page 6.
Thank you.
Finally, the time has arrived, and we begin to see in this birth event of our Lord just how God bends the will of this world to send, so that he may send his son. Here, he has to stop Joseph from doing what would normally be expected, and to take this wife of his as his own, and to name the child, adopting it as his own for the throne of David, as well as recognizing it as God's son. Now, the birth of Jesus Christ took place this way. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph before they came together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. And her husband Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to divorce her quietly. But as he considered these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary as your wife, for that which is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took his wife, but knew her not, until she had given birth to a son, and he called his name Jesus. This is the word of the Lord. We continue with the next hymn. A question that is asked time and time again in the life of the Christian. How can God do this for me? We find the answer as it is given to Mary. With God, nothing is impossible, especially in the birth of his son. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you. But she was greatly troubled at the saying and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there shall be no end. And Mary said to the angel, How will this be, since I am a virgin? And the angel answered her, The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, your relative Elizabeth in her old age has also conceived a son, and this is her sixth month with her who is called barren. For nothing will be impossible with God. And Mary said, Behold, I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word. And the angel departed from her. This is the word of the Lord. We continue with the next hymn. honor of the reading about the birth of our Lord, please rise. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration when Quirinius was governor of Syria, and all went to be registered, each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
First group of outcasts, to let them know that the kingdom of God belongs to all, even sinners such as ourselves. And in the same region there were shepherds out in the field keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased." This is the word of our Lord. We continue with the singing of the next hymn, followed by the taking of the offering.
Amen.
There's a word in this text that oftentimes when I preached on it, I kind of just skipped over this verse because after all, I had spent so much time doing the other ones and it was about time and people were falling asleep. It was time to wrap it up. But note what Mary does here. She doesn't just ponder, she treasures. She considers important. She holds as highest regard all those things that had happened concerning the birth of her son. It is a lesson for us as we sing these hymns, and by the way, you're joining the choirs of angels tonight. We also treasure, consider important, and hold dear the birth of our Savior, and treasure as we ponder these things. We read, "But Mary treasured all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds, they returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God." We continue with the singing of the hymn, "A Great and Mighty Wonder." Dearest Jesus, hear our humble prayer on this Christmas Eve as we gather once again in festive spirit to celebrate the wonders of your birth. We confess that all the words that we speak and we sing to your glory this night fall far short of the praise that we owe you, our God, who left your throne in heaven to appear here in lowliness as our Savior from sin. That stable was your first home, a manger was your first bed. Yet for our sakes, you endured far deeper humiliation than this. For you came to bear the cross, the shame, the suffering, and even the death which we sinners deserve for our sins. We thank you for coming here and sharing our human nature. For you did this that we might share your glory and immortality in heaven. We thank you for your marvelous love, which made you willing to sacrifice yourself on the cross for us. And we thank you for the joy of being saved and for the privilege of living our lives to you. Keep us all in the true faith and direct our footsteps from day to day with the light of your love and the truth that shines tonight so brightly in our hearts. In your mercy, beam the gospel message of salvation to every nation and people. Convert the hearts of sinners everywhere that they may rejoice with us at your birth. Find comfort in the sacrifice you made for us on the cross. And join together with us in praying as you have taught us, our Father, who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be and abide with you all. Amen. Please remain standing for the processional hymn. I would like to welcome everyone and remind us that at 7 o'clock we are doing our candlelight service and communion, and I'd like to welcome you to come back and join us for that as well. So with that, go in peace, serve the Lord.